guys, welcome back to my channel and happy Thursday. Normally, I always put out videos on a Sunday, but we are starting something very special that will be my first time doing something like this because I only just recently started this channel. But we're gonna do something that I'm calling DIY December, and this is the kickoff for it. So for DIY December, I want to put out videos twice a week for the month of December. And we're starting a little bit early this week in the end of November so that we can do some fun transitional projects moving from fall Thanksgiving time into winter Christmas time. So for DIY December, we are going to be doing videos every Thursday and Sunday. This is the goal that I'm setting for myself, to be able to give you guys more content, more projects. And I know a lot of you are going to have breaks from work or time where your kids aren't at school or whatever it may be. You might have some extra time on your hands during the holidays. And so this is the perfect time to be able to kind of dive into some of these projects and do things that are really fun and fulfilling and creative and enjoyable for you. I hope that you guys enjoy the start of our DIY December, and I hope that you're able to tune in twice a week on Thursday and Sunday to do these projects with me and have a fun, creative Christmas season. For today's video, we are going to be doing another one of our transitional holiday pieces, kind of in the same vibe of what we did last week, where we did the transitional centerpiece. I wanted to do another video like that because we're not quite into December and we haven't fully left fall and Thanksgiving behind us, but it is just a couple days away. So if you're like me, I love Christmas, and so it's hard for me to not start those projects early because it's so exciting for me. This week we're going to be doing three projects. These projects are super fun because you're going to be able to use them throughout multiple seasons. And I really like to do stuff like that because it's more budget friendly, it's time efficient, and it keeps the base element in place and you only have to swap something out to make it fresh and new. The three projects that we're going to be doing, we are going to make our own decorative ladder, and we're going to decorate that for Christmas time. We are also going to be swapping out our window display that I did a few videos back where we did the crescent moon wreaths for Halloween and fall. We're going to take those down and we're going to put up some Christmas themed decorations on our stick window display because I really, really love how that's been looking. I think it's beautiful in the evening and from the window outside and even from inside the house. So I want to keep that up and just put up some Christmas decor. And then the last thing that we're going to be doing is making some decor for the backs of chairs, or you could use these on cabinets or something like that. I'm going to be putting them on the backs of my dining room chairs. All three of these DIYs are super budget friendly. Everything was really inexpensive to make. I will break down the cost of everything as we move through it in the video so that you can see what it costs to do each of these projects. And so if you're interested in seeing how to make those projects and doing those with me, then stick around and watch this video, and we're gonna get right into our transitional decor DIYs. All right, so we're gonna start off by making the decorations for the backs of the chairs for in my dining room. For this, we're gonna be making some neutral toned Christmas-inspired acorns, but they're very light on the Christmas, so this will help us to use them now while it's still November and Thanksgiving time, and then we can add to it as we move into Christmas, or just keep them more like a neutral holiday decor piece that we leave out for Christmas and add to the table to kind of amp that up. So we're gonna get started on making it. This is an interesting one because it's made in a way that I think maybe you wouldn't think of right away, but it's gonna turn out really, really cool. We need to take our bamboo spoons, and we want to cut the spoon part off of the handle. To do that, you can see right here in this spoon that I have that it kind of has like a little indent, and that's where I'm going to be cutting. And it just makes it so that the bamboo doesn't splinter. So it looks like that. It doesn't splinter at all when you cut it in that little indent, and you're not going to see this end piece when we're done, so it doesn't matter if it looks kind of funny. You're only going to see the bottom half of the spoon. So we're going to cut a bunch of these, and then we'll go to our next step. And the handles we will not need for this project, but I would suggest, if you have the space or if you're interested, throwing these in a Ziploc and keeping them, because I'm certain that we can end up using this in a future project. So I like to keep scraps like that so that I don't waste them. And then when future projects come around, it doesn't cost you anything because you already saved that. So I usually just put it in a bin with like leftover supplies. Okay, so we got a few cut to kind of get us started. We're gonna need more than this, but this is a good start. So what we're gonna be doing is is laying these spoons down with hot glue on our foam, starting from the bottom, like skinny point, and going about halfway up. So you'll only need to go about halfway up. You're kind of layering them so that they're alternating but overlapping. So you'll see what I mean as we get started. It's a really easy process. You're just gonna take one of these spoons, lay your hot glue on the top side of the spoon, so like the part that's curved in. And then what you wanna do is put your spoon on the narrow edge, just like that. So you want it to kind of be towards the point so that when you put your other one in, you can't really see the point very much. That's the goal. They're kind of touching like that. Okay, so that's our first one, and now we're gonna lay the other one to be touching in the center, just like that. Our next ones are going to go opposite, and they're not going to touch in the center, but they are going to overlap over the spoons that we laid down to make like a little four-point start to our acorn. There's our first one, and we'll do one more. And this goes really quickly once you get the hang of it. So this is a pretty quick project to do, especially like if you want to do this for Thanksgiving as a transitional piece from Thanksgiving to Christmas. But if you are having family over for Thanksgiving, this is something you could whip together in like less than an hour in the afternoon before they come if you wanted to add something like this to your seating arrangement. So we have our first layer down, and what we want to do now is start to kind of layer them in rows going up. So our next one we're going to place over our first and second layer like this. So you want it about halfway, you don't want it fully covering, and you want it to be in this open space so that it starts to be kind of layering off center from each other, if that makes sense. We don't want them exactly lined up, we want them off center. So we're going to cut some more spoons, and we're going to keep adding probably two more rows until we get about to this point halfway, and then we'll switch it up and do a different technique for the top half. So now that the base of our acorn's all done, we're gonna work with the top half. The next thing that we will do is we're gonna take our twine, and what I'm going to do is I'm gonna work with the twine while it's still on the wheel because I don't know how much twine I'm going to need because we're gonna wrap this top part of our acorn, and I don't wanna have to cut it and have cut and start spots in my wrapping. So I'm just gonna leave it and work with it like this. So you wanna start by making a little loop that we can hang it from. You can do it as big or as small as you want. I'm gonna make mine large enough that I can put ribbon through it. It'll be about like this big. And all that I'm gonna do is I'm gonna find the center point, put a dot of hot glue there, and put my loop down and let it dry. I wanna make sure that I have a little bit of excess hanging off from my loop, so that way as we're wrapping it layers over the excess and it makes it more secure for when these are hanging on our chairs. I'm gonna find my center point as best as I can, put some hot glue there, and then we will lay our loop down like so. So mine is mostly dry. What I'm going to do is start layering my twine in tight circles over and around this top half of my acorn. So I'm gonna add just a little bit of hot glue around the loop that we just made to get the first little spiral going. And we're gonna use the excess that we have, and I'm gonna use one of these little sticks we have as like something to push down with so they can adhere a little bit tighter. And we're just gonna start wrapping our twine. I'm gonna lay some of my hot glue around the edge here, just like a very light layer. You don't want it super thick because of the technique that I'm using. If you're doing it like that, you just want a thin, thin layer. So like that. Then I'm gonna keep it pulled flat to the edge of the acorn and drag it around so that it drags the hot glue in with it. And this makes it so that it pulls really tight against the twine that's already there and makes like a really close-knit spiral, just like that. So here is our acorn with the top all done, and this is what it's looking like so far. I think it's super, super cute, and we're just gonna add some finishing touches to it, and then it'll be ready to put our ribbon on and put it on the back of our chair. The next thing that I wanna do is use some of our pine. So we're gonna take a couple pieces off of our pine, you know, piece that we have, probably like 3 or 4 pieces, and I'm just gonna cut them at the base. And then we also wanna take a couple pieces of our eucalyptus or whatever floral you're going to be using. We have a couple pieces of our eucalyptus, literally like 4 leaves is all that I'm going to be using. And then we have some of our pine as well. What I want to do is add these as just like a decorative little detail at the top. So for now, what I want to do is just kind of glue these pieces on. And I think I'm going to do it where I sort of wrap it around our little loop that we made and then glue it down. And then we can kind of shape them how you want them to go. So I just wrapped it around like that, and then I'm just gonna literally like lift it up and put a couple dots of hot glue underneath and then just press it down so that it glues into place. And I think this really just kind of finishes it off nicely to make it look more seasonal and more intentional for the winter time. There's our first one. We're gonna add a few more just to kind of fill it out. So I do want to add a little bit to this like more empty space right here, and that's where I'm going to put the eucalyptus. I think that this looks really pretty, and it still kind of gives a nod to the fall time while incorporating some of that Christmas colors as well. So you could do eucalyptus like I'm doing, you could do a red floral, or you could go the traditional poinsettia, whatever it is you want to do, or you could leave it with the pine and have that be the end of what you want to add. And there is our acorn all done. So we're going to finish off the last couple of acorns for our chairs, and then we'll add our ribbons and put them on our chairs as decoration. We're going to do is we're going to work on our DIY ladder, our decorative ladder. And so for that, we're going to be making it out of just sticks that you find in your yard. I had 2 massive trees that were weeds growing in the yard that I cut down. Those will be the main stick posts that I use. But really anything that you have in your yard could work for this. However big you want the ladder to be is how long the stick needs to be. And then you'll just need like some rope or twine to go with that. So before we assemble our ladder, I want to work on some of the decorative elements that we're going to be putting onto the ladder so that they're dry and ready to go by the time it's all assembled. My plan for the ladder is to decorate it with some garland, just plain simple garland, and some ornaments, and then maybe some ribbons and some florals. That's kind of the idea that I'm going for. We might throw some bells in there. I know for sure that we're going to use the ornaments to put into our garland, so I want to get those ready. So what I did was I went to Joanne and I got a giant thing of ornaments like this, and this is 25 ornaments. They are plastic, but you won't be able to tell once we've decorated them. This works totally fine. And the ornaments are typically $30. They were on sale for 50% off, and then I had an extra coupon to get $15 off of my order, so that took an extra amount off of it. And then with that, this particular brand also was doing like an add-on sale where if you bought one item, you got 2 for free. So I got this entire thing of ornaments for like $12, $13. And then I also got two cases of bells that were free with the purchase. So I think that's a pretty good deal. I want to do these simple. I want to keep them relatively plain, but I want them to still go with kind of that classic vintage feel that I want Christmas to be in my home. So I want to do these in like a bronzed sort of look. So what I'm thinking that we'll do is we'll take some European gold rubin buff in this little tube here and just apply it to the outside of our ornaments and let them dry. And then that will give us that like vintage gold sort of look. So we're gonna give it a go and see how it turns out. And I think I'll probably do like 10 ornaments like this and see if that's enough. So I'm gonna take our ornament and it's super simple. We're gonna see how this applies because I've actually never applied it to plastic before. I've done it on wood and metal and it works really, really well with those materials, but it's supposed to be able to go on to almost anything. We will see how that goes. I'm just gonna put some on it like that and then rub it around. Really easy, straightforward process. As simple as that. I mean, it's already good to go and I think that looks really nice and vintage and you know, the look that we're going for. So I'm just gonna set this over here to dry and we're just gonna do 9 more just like that. So we're gonna move on to making our ladder. So for this, you're gonna need to collect some sticks of different sizes. However long you want your ladder to be is going to be the length of the biggest two sticks. And then you'll need some shorter ones for the rungs of the ladder. I've been collecting some sticks from my yard. This one is massive. You cannot see the whole thing. It literally is probably like 15 feet tall. So we'll definitely be cutting this down. You're gonna get some that are about this thickness, if possible, work with what you have. But if you can find some in your yard that are thicker like this, these will be best for the main rungs of the ladder because they'll give you more support when you're putting your ladder together to be able to hang decorations and things like that on it. And it's also just going to give it like a longer life because it's going to be sturdier. And then for the rungs of your ladder, you can really just take like regular old sticks. They don't need to be super thick. I really just collected whatever I had in my yard. I have a big pile so that I can kind of cut things down and see what works best and mix and match. And then whatever I don't need can be used for like firewood. The first thing that we need to do is take our two main sticks, which are going to be the vertical posts of your ladder, and decide which ones you're going to use for that, and then figure out the height that you need. So I'm going to be putting mine on my front porch, so I definitely am going to need to cut these down, but that's okay because they kind of taper off and get thinner at the edges, and I want the two vertical posts to be thicker for my ladder. So I'm going to measure these and cut them down, and then we can start to pick out our rungs, and we're going to use some of our twine to tie the rungs of the ladder to the vertical posts. And I'm gonna do my best to walk you guys through this. I did do some research on how to do like lashings to tie things together that are perpendicular. We should be able to make this work and have a nice secure ladder that we can decorate. Okay, so I cut and measured my two vertical posts of my ladder. I measured them to my front porch and this should be like the perfect height to sit I want them to. I did not bring a measuring tape out, so I'm just going to like girl math it. And the width that I'm going to do for my rungs of my ladder is going to be the length of my arm. So I want it to be like that. That's the strategy that I'm going with. Guys, so we are going to start tying our lashings onto our ladder to attach the rungs to the vertical posts. It seems like the best way to do it is with these square lashings. And so I tried it on the bottom rung and tied both off and held it up and everything, and it seems really secure. So we're going to continue on with it. And I'm going to show you all how to do it because a lot of the videos online are pretty confusing in how they explain it. So I'm hoping that I'll be able to explain it a little bit clearer for you
so that you're able to do this really easily and take this project on no problem. How you're going to start is you're going to take your vertical pieces here and lay them side by side. So you want to take your horizontal rung and stick that where you're going to want it to go. So I'm going to put mine about like here, roughly like a foot or so up from the other one. I want to try and keep my vertical pieces going the same distance the whole way up so that it doesn't taper or anything like that. The easiest way that I've found to do this is to have your horizontal piece on the bottom and your vertical pieces on top. Then what you need to do is take a bunch of your twine or rope or whatever it is that you're using. I tend to take like a lot like this, and it's usually more than I need, but you really don't want to run out halfway through because there's no way to add on once you start tying. So you can always put your scraps to the side and use them for some other project.
Okay, so we have our yarn and we're going to start with our clove hitch on the vertical piece underneath our horizontal post. So you're going to lay your cut piece over the vertical post, pass the horizontal piece through the bottom, cross it over, making that X. Bring it under again, and then we want to lift up the top piece and pass it through. Pull it super tight so that you have that clean X look right there. So that's your clove hitch. That's how you're going to start. Make sure it's pulled tight every step of the way. The next thing that we're going to do is take it under our horizontal piece, over the vertical, under the horizontal on the other side here, and then over the vertical like that, and then pull it tight. All right, and we're gonna repeat that process two more times. So we're gonna go under our horizontal, over the vertical, under our horizontal, over the vertical, pull it tight, and then one more time. Under our horizontal, over the vertical, under our horizontal, tight as you can, so you see how they squeeze together right there? That's what you want to see. From here, what we're going to do is we're going to cross this over our horizontal piece right here. So we were here, we want to go here. Now you're going to pass it under the vertical, and we're just wrapping it around everything we just did. Okay. And we want to do that two times. So bring it around, and I like to catch my little tail here in so that it's secured. And then once we're here, now we're going to end with our clove hitch again. So you're going to cross it over the horizontal, bring it over to make your X like that, pass it under again, lift up your top piece, pull it through, and then pull it tight. And there's your clove hitch. And then I just end with a little regular old knot just to make sure nothing slips. Okay, and then I just cut off the excess. You can rewatch this and kind of slow it down. I'll also link below some visuals and videos that I watched if that is helpful for you. We're just gonna repeat this process for all of our rungs up our ladder. So I have two rungs done. I'm gonna do another four and then we'll be ready to decorate our ladder.
All right guys, so here's our ladder all done. Honestly, I'm super, super proud of this. If you guys try this DIY, be prepared to feel so proud of yourself for building a ladder and making these knots. What we're going to do now is we're going to decorate this for Christmas. This is going to be a really fun one because I'm going to put this on my front porch next to my front door. I plan to leave it out there and change it for the seasons and the holidays and have it be like a themed decor piece that I can rotate things through. And I also think it's just super pretty by itself. Like if you don't want to put any decor on it, I think it's pretty. Or you could even use this inside as a blanket ladder and have it against a wall like this and hang your blankets over it, which would be really pretty as well. I have a few things that I'm thinking I will decorate with. So I'll show you what I have and we can kind of play with it together. Okay, so I have a few different decor items that we can decorate with. I have this just plain garland that we can kind of like wrap through it and add different things to. I have some leftover pine cones from when we made this bowl right here, so we can use those. And these are really nice as well because they smell like cinnamon, so they add a look with the pine cones, but they also add a scent so that when people come to your front door, they get the scent of cinnamon, which is really like nice and welcoming for the holidays. I have some red velvet ribbon that we can maybe tie like some bows on or something like that. And I also have these jingle bells, like Christmas bells, that we could use. We could maybe even use the ribbon to string the bells on and kind of drape it down the ladder, something to kind of play with. And then the last thing that I have is these ornaments that we made, the bronze ornaments. And so my thought for this was that we could either do like the bells where we hang it on the ribbon, or what I was thinking is we could hot glue them into the garland to kind of give it like a little bit more interest and detail. Okay, so this garland ended up being the perfect length, so that's super exciting. I think it looks really nice. I think I want to add the ribbon next and see how that looks, and then we'll know how many ornaments and pine cones and things we need to add to the garland. Last thing that we're going to do is hot glue just a couple of little pine cones and ornaments onto our garland throughout, and then it'll be ready to put outside. Okay, so for our last DIY, I want to swap out the window display that we did during fall time. We did crescent moon wreaths on like a stick window display, and that has been like one of my favorite things that we've made. It's super, super simple. It's literally just a stick from your yard again that we wrapped in some fairy lights, and then you can change out the decor hanging underneath it to match whatever season you're in. But it looks so beautiful. I have it in our sunroom, and so you can see it from outside in the front yard or from the street and inside of our house, and I just love how it looks hanging in the window. So I definitely want to swap that out to Christmas time so that we can keep that going, but it goes with the decor of the house. So we need to take those down and put up some Christmas decor in the window. I was going through Pinterest and trying to figure out what I wanted the window display to look like. I wanted to keep it simple because I do typically hang some wreaths on the outside of the window as well, and I'm going to do that when we decorate the outside of the house with Christmas lights probably this week sometime. So I saw this really cool idea, and they had taken fresh evergreen clippings. It was super pretty the way it was hanging. So I want to try and get that feeling from what I'm making. I don't think that it's going to look exactly the same because I don't have fresh evergreen clippings. So I am going to be using some faux florals and pine and garlands and things to try to make it work. But that's kind of like the look that I'm going for. I pulled a few things that I had left over from other projects or for future projects, and we're gonna try and take some clippings from each of these and mix and match to give it some different color and texture and things like that throughout, so it's not just one note. I'm gonna be hanging it from fishing line. That's what I did with the wreaths that are currently up in that room, and it looks really pretty because they look like they're floating. They don't look like they're attached to the stick, so I like that look a lot. So we're gonna hang the pieces and the bundles that we make from fishing line. My plan is to clip off some of these and start making little bundles and then attach them all to long pieces of fishing line. And then when we get over to the window, we can tie them shorter or longer to get the shape that we want for the display. Okay, so I have all of our branches tied off and ready to go. So we're going to hang them off of our branch in the window display to make like a tree shape. Ours is going to be a little bit more sparse and probably smaller than the one in the inspiration picture, but we're going to use these and see how it goes, and then if we need to add some, we can do that. Okay, so this is the current display that we have up from fall. So I'm going to be taking down these two wreaths, and my original thought was to have a large Christmas tree shape with the branches in the center, similar to the inspiration photo, but in thinking about it some more, I think what I'm going to do is two mini trees. So hanging where the wreaths are right now, we'll do two of the same shape but smaller. And I want to do that for a couple of reasons. One, because if we do a large one, then it's going to be in the center where we have the window framing, and so that will block a lot of it from the outside of the house. And also, if we do it in the center, then when I hang our wreaths on the outside of the house when we decorate with Christmas lights, they're going to be overlapping. So I'm thinking that if I do two smaller trees in the windows themselves, then the wreaths will offset them and it'll be like every other, and that'll look better from the outside of the house. That's what we're going to try. We're going to see if we have enough greenery to be able to do it, and then we'll hang them and see how it goes. Video and the three transitional DIYs that we did. I think they all turned out really, really perfect for moving from one season to the next. And I also hope that you're able to use these pieces for when you have family over, and that you're able to kind of throw these together to add little special touches to your home so that it feels really seasonal and homey and just cozy and inviting. And that's kind of always my goal with Christmas time and the decorations I'm putting out, is for everything to feel really cozy and warm and inviting. So I hope that you got that feeling from the decor that we made today, and that you make it for your home as well. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. We have a ton of really fun projects coming your way. We're going to be kicking off DIY December, and we'll have another video out on Sunday for you guys. Don't forget to tune in to watch that. We're going to have videos every Thursday and Sunday through December. So I'll see you guys on Sunday for some more holiday DIYs.